Mr. Al Ghassim. Good morning and welcome to Miraya Breakfast Show.
Good morning and thank you for having me.
Yes, just briefly tell us, what was the purpose of your visit to South Sudan?
This visit is undertaken in pursuance of Resolution 2304, which requested the Secretary General to submit a report on the implementation of the mandate of UNMISS, including the Regional Protection Force, and to make recommendations on how best to adjust UNMISS to the situation on the ground and enhance the efficiency of the implementation of its mandate.
Yes, and as you came, who did you meet and what are some of the key issues that you've discussed?
Well, we met a wide range of South Sudanese stakeholders. We had in-depth exchange of views with a delegation of cabinet members led by the Minister for Cabinet Affairs and including a number of other officials. We met with the Speaker of the Transitional National Legislative Assembly. We met with the Chief Justice. We also undertook field trips to Malakal and Bentiu, and I would like to add that prior to my arrival, we had an advance team which also met with a wide range of South Sudanese and non-South Sudanese stakeholders.
Yes, and so far, are you happy with the implementation process of the peace agreement, or are you happy with your visit and the outcome of your visit?
Well, we see the opportunity of the visit, of course, to assess the situation, and as I said, to exchange with a wide range of stakeholders, both from South Sudan and from the diplomatic community here in Juba. We discussed a number of issues of common concern linked to the deployment of the Regional Protection Force, which was mandated by the Security Council in Resolution 2304. We discussed issues linked to the freedom of movement for UNMISS and for the humanitarian community. As you know, we face very serious challenges on the ground, and we believe that it is important that every effort be made, that full cooperation be availed to UNMISS and to the humanitarian community to enable them to implement their mandate in support of the people of South Sudan. And the efficiency of the support they can extend depends, of course, on the level of cooperation they receive from the South Sudanese stakeholders. So it's a point we have made to the South Sudanese, to our South Sudanese interlocutors. We emphasize, of course, the urgency of the deployment of the RPF. We also emphasize the importance of continued efforts to ensure an inclusive implementation of the peace process to enable us indeed achieve the peace and security that the people of South Sudan have been yearning for many, many years.
Yes, just recently the government came out, of course, and said they have accepted the deployment of the protection force to South Sudan. Do we know when this will be effective? I mean, when will they be on the ground?
Well, we are working to ensure that the deployment takes place as quickly as possible. As you may know, there are a number of conditions that need to be met and that need to be created to facilitate that process. The government has consented to the deployment. We have some details to resolve, and we hope that those details will be resolved quickly to enable us to proceed with the deployment. And the sooner the force is here, the better, we believe, because the force will contribute indeed to creating a better sense of security and helping create conditions for an inclusive implementation of the peace process.
Yes, what happens next after this assessment visit?
What happens, we'll be preparing a report that would inform recommendations by the Secretary General to the Security Council, and then Security Council will take a decision on the matter. As you know, the mandate of UNMISS was extended by the Security Council in Resolution 2304 until 15 December. Before that date, of course, a new resolution has to be adopted based on the recommendations that would be put forward by the Secretary General.
Mr. Ghassim, what is your final remarks on your visit to South Sudan?
Well, I just would like to say how proud I am of the work being done by our peacekeepers and the humanitarian community and extremely difficult and challenging conditions. You have been to Malakal, I've been to Bentiu, as I indicated. I did visit POC sites here also in Juba, and one could see how challenging the conditions are, how difficult the conditions are, but also how committed and how dedicated our peacekeepers are. I would like also to add that as United Nations, we're committed to helping the people of South Sudan to working closely with the government and all other South Sudanese stakeholders to help them bring to an end the crisis afflicting their country. South Sudan has suffered so much. The people of South Sudan have suffered so much. It's high time for all South Sudanese stakeholders to truly, genuinely commit themselves to an inclusive peace process to bring to an end the suffering inflicted upon their people.
Mr. Ghassim, thank you so much for coming to me.